Hi, I'm Tatiana Veneruso, Public Art Coordinator for Athens-Clarke County, and you're watching Snapshot Six. This video will take a look at the efforts of the Unified Government for the month of September, including the installation of the first 10 inductees for the Athens Music Walk of Fame. We're excited to announce the next 5 inductees for 2021, Art Rosenbaum, Bob Cole, Lowdown and Duddy, Nucci Space, and Linda Phillips, and Of Montreal.
In August, the Athens Cultural Affairs Commission announced the launch of the Athens Music Walk of Fame and its first 10 inductees. A local resident committee appointed by Mayor Kelly Gertz selected the inductees. The Athens Music Walk of Fame is a 2-square-block area in downtown Athens, bounded by Pulaski Street, West Washington Street, North Lumpkin Street, and West Clayton Street. The walk passes several renowned music venues in western downtown, including the Morton Theater, the 40 Watt Club, and the Georgia Theater. Bronze plaques installed in the sidewalk honor the performers who have contributed to Athens' musical legacy. Through a competitive process, a panel of community members selected Alan Sutton, an Athens-based multidisciplinary designer, and his plaque design. The plaque design is inspired by both a guitar pick and a location pin to illustrate the link between the medium and the place it was created. The Athens-Clarke County Transportation and Public Works Department's Streets and Drainage Division installed the plaques in the sidewalk. The first 10 Athens Music Walk of Fame inductees are the B-52s, Danger Mouse, Brian Joseph Burton, the Drive-By Truckers, the Elephant Six Recording Company, Hall Johnson, Neil Patman, Pylon, REM, Vic Chestnut, and Widespread Panic. Additional artists will be selected for induction into the Athens Music Walk of Fame in the coming years. For more information and a list of the inductees, visit accgov.com/publicart. Ever wonder how drinking water in Athens-Clarke County is treated? Now you can see the process without leaving home. In August, the Public Utilities Department's Water Conservation Office debuted their drinking water treatment plant tour video. With the pandemic limiting opportunities for tours of the J.G. Beecham Water Treatment Plant, the video provides a behind-the-scenes look at how water reaches the plant, the treatment process, the testing process, and how water is stored for distribution to the community. To view the video and see other water-related educational resources, visit accgov.com/thinkatthesink. ACCGov's Stormwater Management Program was named an Educational Program of Excellence in the Watershed category by the Georgia Association of Water Professionals. This award is presented each year to municipalities that demonstrate excellence and innovation in water education. Stormwater's education program encompasses K-12 schools, businesses, and public education and outreach. It also includes providing resources for home-based education. The Stormwater Management Program considers education and public awareness a critical piece of stormwater management. For more information on stormwater's education resources, visit accgov.com/stormwater. The Solid Waste Department celebrated the 25th anniversary of the opening of the Athens-Clarke County Recovered Materials Processing Facility, or RMPF. The facility opened August 31, 1995, as a one-of-a-kind recycling facility in Georgia. Recycling at the facility is the effort of the public-private partnership between ReCommunity Recycling and ACCGov. The $2.5 million facility was built with private funds, but ACCGov owns the property and oversees the contract. The RMPF accepts over 30 different types of recyclable materials in a single stream with paper, bottles and cans, and other accepted items mixed together. The facility can process up to 120 tons of recyclables per 8-hour shift. Currently, the recycling facility processes about 75 tons per day, or 1,500 tons per month. For more information on recycling, or the RMPF, Visit accgov.com/recycling. Despite not being able to perform for live crowds last fall, Athens Creative Theatre continued to provide entertainment to the community by releasing the third and fourth installments of their digital script series in the fall of 2020. The series showcased actors and actresses performing plays from their homes in a virtual meeting format. The scripts showcased in August were Stranger in the Attic and Orchid for a Lady. Additionally, the monthly virtual choir featured instrumentalist and vocalist from the ACT family performing There's a Fine, Fine Line from the musical Avenue Q. For more information about Athens Creative Theatre, visit accgov.com/ACT. The Magistrate Court held a public swearing-in ceremony for its newest judge, Donarell Green IV. Due to pandemic concerns, the event was held on the steps of the courthouse. An Athens native and local attorney, Green fills a seat formerly held by Tony Pomerain, who retired. Green graduated from Clark Central High School and received his B.A. from Morris Brown College and his J.D. from the Stetson University College of Law. For more information on the Magistrate Court, visit accgov.com/magistratecourt.
Thank you for watching Snapshot 6. We'll see you again next month.